So is she trying to trap you right now?
Yeah. She's like, tell me the truth. I know you and him have something going on.
Hello world, my name's Steven LeConte. You might know me as the guy who gives people advice. Basically, people DM me their problems at StevenLC on Instagram and Twitter, and I try my very, very best to solve them. Quick disclaimer before we start, I'm not a therapist. Therapists have things like accreditations, degrees, certificates. I have a major in theater and a really cute dog. Cosmo, you want a treat? Good boy. Cosmo, say hi. Hi. We're gonna give advice, okay, buddy? All right, go back to bed. So I just received a DM on Instagram that has absolutely rattled me. Let me read it for you. Dear Steven, that's me. This has been very hard for me to process and deal with. My friend thinks I'm sleeping with her boyfriend. I'm not, I would never. She confronted me about it and I tried my best to be transparent and prove my innocence. She thinks I'm a liar and a great actress. She started to tell all of our mutual friends about it, and thankfully they don't believe her, but it hurts to know that she would try to tarnish my reputation like that. Is there a way to prove my innocence? Woof. I have like a million follow-up questions after reading this DM. Luckily, the person who sent it has agreed to get on the phone with me, which is very exciting. This has never happened before. We're not gonna tell you her name, we're not gonna show her face, just to preserve anonymity here, but let's get her on the line. Okay, can you hear me? Are you there?
Yes, thank you so much for this.
Oh my God, thank you so much for agreeing to get on the phone with me. I just read your DM. Can you just like walk me through what happened here?
It was during the whole pandemic and the lockdowns, and it was right after restrictions started to get lifted. She said that she needed to vent. So I'm like, okay, let's just meet up somewhere that's safe. We were just kind of like gossiping and talking. And then all of a sudden she's like, can you go on your phone? I was like, okay. She's like, go on your Facebook. I'm like, okay, yeah, what's the gossip? What's the tea? I wasn't suspecting anything. She's like, okay, go on his Facebook account. I'm like, okay, it's about him. What are we looking at? Did he post something weird? Like, was he tagged in something? She's like, okay, go on your messages. I was like, okay. And at this point, I'm just kind of like, what are we actually looking at?
So is she trying to trap you right now?
Yeah. And then she's like, go on your Instagram. I'm like, okay, this is getting weird. But, you know, yeah. I'm going along. I have nothing to hide. So she's like, tell me the truth. And I was like, I don't know what you're talking about. And she's like, I know you and him have something going on. I'm like, you're looking through my apps. Like, clearly I have nothing to hide. I'm like, and I would never do that.
So does she have any like evidence that she would point to say like, this is how I know it's happening?
The way that she rationalized it was that he had made a weird comment once. He was like, yeah, I can listen to her talk about this for hours. And then there was another incident. The day before we had met up, he knew about it. So then he texted me. He's like, hey, I heard that you're coming over, so I'm making you something to eat. He sent me a picture of food. And I was like, oh, no, no. I hope you didn't make that today because we're not meeting up till tomorrow. Apparently what happens is that my name had popped up on his phone. She's like, oh, what are you guys talking about? And he got defensive. He's like, why are you looking at my phone?
The texting was innocent, but because he got defensive, now she's panicked.
And I was trying to make her understand that it's not me. There's obviously something sketchy. He's definitely gaslighting her, lying, and hiding stuff from her.
If you had to take a wild guess, would you guess that maybe this boyfriend is a cheater?
Yes. I always got this feeling from him that he wasn't always like the most loyal or the best boyfriend, but they were like super in love. So I was like, so for it. I'm like, hey, if it's working out, it's working out. I guess something happened during the whole lockdown.
She's been going now to your friends and like telling all of your friends that this happened. Is that right?
Yes. The way that I found out was that I get like a text message and it's a coworker. He's like, look, I'm not judging you.
I'm not judging you is absolutely the worst way to start any conversation.
At this party, with a bunch of people that we both know, she was like, there's something going on between both of them. It was like super scary for me to go up to my coworkers and our friends and be like, it's not true. They're like, hey, we know she's going through something right now and she's lashing out on you. Since then, she had repeatedly sent me text messages asking me these weird questions like, where do you park? Where do you guys meet up?
She's really like taking this and running with it. Like she's asking for details on the affair that isn't happening.
Yes.
Thank you so much for answering all my questions. It definitely helps me before I give advice just to get a better sense of like, what the heck is going on here? So I will report back to you when I have some advice. Sound good?
Yeah, thank you so much for helping me.
So The question in your DM was, is there a way to prove your innocence? And my answer is, maybe? But I honestly, at this point, don't think you should bother. She shouldn't have to like take a black light into your bedroom and like dust your headboard for her boyfriend's fingerprints to believe you. No, if you have a real friendship with this person, then saying it's not true should be enough. It's pretty clear that your friend is operating from a place of paranoia and distrust, which probably means that her relationship has a good amount of paranoia and distrust. It tends to be that there's like no smoke without fire, so if she's sensing that there's something going on, there probably is something going on. Just not with you. I hope she gets out of what appears to be a really toxic situation, but none of that can excuse the horrible, unacceptable way that she's treating you right now. It's very likely that she is in a situation where she's the victim, but now she's creating a new situation where you're the victim. I once heard this quote on Oprah that has always stuck with me, "Hurt people hurt people." Think about it. Let's talk about where you go from here. Realistically, the only thing you can do at this point is just disengage from the situation and walk the hell away. The only way that the two of you can realistically move forward is with trust. And honestly, I don't think she's going to be able to trust anyone in her life until she dumps the man who really seems to be wreaking havoc upon it. I hope your friend has people in her life who can lead her to this realization. You are not the person for that job. I am officially done giving advice for the day, but now it's your turn. Sound off in the comments with your advice for her. If you happen to have a problem of your own, please DM me. I can't guarantee that I'll fix your whole damn life, but I'll try my very, very best. High five. This is what I do with my life.